Hey, everybody. Welcome back to Vanquish here on Sequential Saturday. I am
Hey, baby. I'm Matt. What's going on? Oh, by the way.
Yeah. We got past that point with all of the the big robots, robo-spiders.
Wait, hold on. Octo-spiders.
There was some things over here that I didn't get, so got to get them. Yeah, we're playing Vanquish.
Woo!
I'm sure that is... upgrades.
Upgrade.
Good for you, good for me, good for everybody.
Yeah, delicious upgrade.
Assault rifle magazine capacity.
That's a car.
Well, just to hell with it, man. How do I go into cover again? Oh, X is telling me right there.
Right.
All right, so Vanquish. We're heading down. We're killing off them Ruskies.
Ruskies.
Them nazi Ruskies or whatever. All right, so what do we got? Cover usage, zero. Jeff's trial, death. Friendly confirm friendlies, KIA 10.
Woo!
That's pretty good.
Going down.
Yeah, what's our total score? 62 total.
Yeah.
Yep, total friendly kills. All right. Let's see what's going on here. What? I just seriously, every time he does that, I want him to pull out an electric guitar.
And
just
go, woo, 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 woo.
Yeah, exactly. All right, so what's up? Hey, whoa. Okay, cool.
Oh, shit.
So we're trying. Oh no! Jason the Wheeled Warriors.
So I would play the shit out of a Jason the Wheeled Warriors video game.
Damn straight.
Yeah, what were you saying?
Tungsten up this tunnel's ass.
Yeah! Shove it up there.
Oh shit! Rail gun.
Please, Matt. That is the penis accelerator cannon.
Is that what it is?
Yeah, the PAC we call it. What did he just? Did he just implicate? Did he just say, "Man, we fucked this colony good"?
I mean, we didn't even pull out.
Damn.
I mean, the hell of it.
Damn, Mecha
Santa. She can get an abortion.
Yikes! Youch!
Yowza!
Hey, don't call me a piece of shit.
Like, you're a.
No, it just said user POS down there.
Oh,
I was like,
okay.
Wee-how!
Sorry, buddy. We merged with you. Rocket launcher!
Yeah, double rocket launcher. Woo! What does it mean? All right, let's get...
Double rockets all the way across the sky.
Let's put one right in your turret. Ho-ho!
In your butthole!
Yeah!
Boosh. Whoa.
Oh, shit. Like three of these guys? Well, good thing I got a rocket launcher. Beep, 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 beep. Boosh. Damn it. Not even dead?
Oh.
Fucking,
we got one.
All right.
Well, I don't know if that was us,
Let's get whatever's in here real fast. No, that's the LFE.
That's the thing that's like the big bubble gun.
Oh, okay. I don't know what that is, but it sounds dumb.
It does, yeah.
So I'm going to go. Oh, shit. This is too far.
Whoa,
well, that's a missile. That is straight up a missile.
This is the
part where Jeff got a little bit too excited.
Yeah, Jeff got a little too saucy.
Yep,
got
to get away. Got to get away.
Oh, shit,
no.
On the wrong side of that thing.
I'm on the wrong side of everything.
You're on the wrong side of history,
Jeff. On the wrong side of every, all arguments as well as history.
Yep.
All right, let's get behind that thing.
Jay is not...
It's
not pro gay marriage. Sorry, I'm just.
What?
I'm just kidding.
Okay.
No, I'm just.
I mean,
yes, you're on the wrong side of history.
Is probably the wrong side of history.
Yep.
I am pro gay marriage, just for the,
Well, now it sounds like you're overcompensating.
Yeah. Well, I.
Sounds
constantly.
Like you're overcorrecting, a la Donald Trump.
I am constantly overcompensating. God, you fucker! Just die already with bullets in your face!
It is a little upsetting that, Trump has actually been saying things that I kind of agree with lately.
Oh, no, Matt. Oh, Matt.
Well, he's been saying...
You're history's greatest monster now. Don't you know that's what happened?
I know.
Oh, shit. Get him. Shoot him. So he knows how I didn't use the melee there and get killed the way that I normally do?
Yep.
I want that upgrade. I want that upgrade, Matt.
That upgrade.
Wait, am I in slow motion still?
You don't get that dick. Anyway,
it's not really the same thing, but
you don't know.
I don't. That's correct.
It's just like, I don't know, like Trump. What did Trump? Trump actually said,
why has Saturday become like our politics and social justice
because we have to reflect
day.
On the week that we had.
Oh, okay. All right. Fair enough.
No,
so this week, Matt found out that he's a xenophobic Republican.
That is not what I said. I just... Never mind. I was going to say something really horrible.
No, you say it.
I was going to say something really horrible, like, I just hate the Jews.
Oh, no. Okay, don't say it. I take it all back.
No.
Okay, I'm going to get behind this guy.
I think the Jews are hilarious.
No, Matt! God damn it. Every goddamn... You're not going to be on Rage Select. I'm going to have... The ACLU is going to be all up in my Rage Select.
Oh, we don't want that.
No, wait, hold on. Oh, shit. No.
Oh, man.
I mean, I don't mind. Like, we're just, you know, we're doing our thing.
You know, and your brother's the one who learned how to use the power arm a long time ago. I mean, I don't understand why it's taking you so long, Jeff.
Damn it. Ah, fuck. Garbage.
You know, see, I'm telling
your cousin
Jimmy knows how to not get shot in slow motion.
My vanquished Jewish grandma again?
Yeah. As we have established.
Oh, shit. Oh, no.
I know that happened to your cousin Mikey once, but you know what? He didn't graduate from college.
Shut the fuck up. God damn it.
I can make you some fish if you want.
I'm
sorry.
I don't even know what's going on here anymore. All right. Boom.
Sorry, not sorry. Matt Frank.
2016.
Anyone who follows me on Facebook knows that I do nothing but piss and moan about
everything.
Race, you know, fucking Scarlett Johansson is fucking being a Japanese character. Fuck you.
I don't see any problem with why. I don't understand why people wouldn't be upset about that. But I personally, I keep coming down to the whole thing of like, well, is there any possibility that movie's going to be anything but a steaming pile of poop garbage?
Yeah.
So who the fuck cares?
Yeah,
they're
going to
fuck it up, you guys.
Yep.
It's going to be all fucked up. It's like already.
They're going to miss the entire point of Ghost in the Shell.
Yep.
It's gonna be like Ultraviolet or Aeon Flux. It's gonna be this crappy adaptation.
And that's maybe why I'm so salty, Matt, is because Aeon Flux, when I was a teenager, was like my jam.
Right.
Like the lock-on laser. That sounds pretty rad.
Let's try that.
Let's get the lock-on laser. Whoa. Lock it on. Is it locked?
I don't know. Fire it.
I don't understand. I'm doing it. It's not doing anything.
You're
it's just
shot at, dude.
Well, I'm trying to use the lock-on laser.
I need to use it. Whoa.
Uh-oh. It's the lambent.
Robots.
It's the fucking. Is it the?
It's the robots.
No, it's the. It's the locust are coming up.
Yeah, that's it. The lambent. God damn.
No, but see, here's the thing. So when I was a kid, Aeon Flux, right?
Right, Aeon Flux.
Started with the anime, or with the cartoons, the cartoon shorts.
Right, right.
And I loved them.
Right,
they were so like subversive
cool
and different.
And
and like it was this like kick-ass lady with a weird haircut, and I was like, great, this is all cool. And then they made the series, and I was like, this is great. With like, you know, they're not quite as good as pithy as the shorts. But you know what? They're still good. They're still good.
Didn't she die in each one of the shorts or something? Wasn't that the gimmick?
Yes.
I remember that now.
She did die in every one of the shorts, I'm pretty sure. There was the first one, like she dies, and then there's like a weird scene where she's in like the foot fetish afterlife.
Oh, yeah. That is weird.
It was a very strange one. But yeah, I loved Aeon Flux. And then they were like, we're making a movie. And I was like, great. And then I saw it, and I was like, bad Aeon Flux movie.
No.
I am no longer excited. Ooh, go between your legs. Teen Wolf.
Baba booey.
Like, there's one in particular, and I probably have mentioned this before, and if you follow Drunk Jeff on Facebook, I feel like I should make a new Facebook account that's just nothing but
Jeff.
The drunk shit that I post. What are you doing? Whoa.
Jesus, that was terrifying.
I've posted a few times. I'm going to go with the rocket launcher because that's better than the other one. There is one of the Aeon Flux shorts out there is called War, Matt.
Uh-huh.
I don't know if you've ever seen this one. Probably you have.
Is that the one about the two people who are on the other side of the fence?
No. It's one of the shorts. It's actually not one of the
30-minute
episodes. That one that you're talking about is called, God damn, I used to know the name of all of them.
Right.
I actually even, it's funny because they're hard to find online, and I actually have, it's one of the few DVDs that I keep around.
Oh, shit.
It's a DVD box set of every episode of Aeon Flux.
Shit, son.
So it's got all the regular episodes, and like when I went online looking for that, it's even kind of hard to find like pirate versions of them online.
Whoa.
But War is really interesting because it starts out like all the short War.
Mm-hmm.
It you guys can actually go look this up on Aeon or on Vimeo if you have never seen it before.
Mm.
It's all about subverting expectations.
Okay,
so it starts with Aeon Flux and she's like she's killing a bunch of the Brennians who are the blue guys.
Right,
and then like she's going like she's got bodies everywhere.
Oh, I know.
And then a guy like
about.
Grabs her legs and she loses her gun and. Then he's like, he's going to kill her, and she starts making, like sexy tongue motions at him.
I remember this now,
right, while her buddy is sneaking up to save her, and at the last second, he just shoots her in the face and turns around and shoots her buddy in the face, too.
Right.
And then that guy goes on to do this big, like, he attacks the Monikans, and then he's like killing the shit out of them. Oh shit. And then it comes to a scene where he's just like, he's blowing them up. He goes into their base. Yeah. And then there's a guy who comes out and he's got a sword. And it's basically a subversion of the Indiana Jones scene with the guy with the sword.
Right.
Because he like does this little ninja sword flip. And then the guy looks at his gun and he goes to shoot the other guy. And when he goes to shoot him, he blocks it with his sword and then kills him with the sword.
Yeah, I remember this now. I remember this.
And then he like goes up into a carrier and there's this big action sequence where he's like just cutting all these people down.
Yeah.
And if you blink, you'll miss it. But the last person he tries to cut down, she just ducks and then shoots him. And then she goes in and kills a bunch of people. And she's like rescuing this guy. And there's a cutaway part where they show like some oil dripping, and the very last scene is her and the guy that she rescued, and they're trying to escape, but they're running towards right where the oil thing is, and so it's like the implication there is that they're gonna die too,
right?
And I was watching that the other night, like I literally was watching that like 3 nights ago.
Wow.
And I was like, I would watch 90 minutes of this where every 45 seconds it just transitioned to a new person.
Yeah.
And completely subverted all expectations.
Well, I think we were talking about that with like the Silent Hill movie or something. Like, wouldn't it be crazy if we were like, yeah, if somebody actually made like a big budget movie where it was something like that, but they won't do that anymore. But I know what you're talking about. I had
one of my college
Whoa.
Who's this guy? I don't know if he belongs here.
It's a professor.
It's the guy who built the place.
Okay.
Candide. See, look at his haircut. He's a professor. He knows science.
That's awesome.
He's like, I just shot him. Was that the right way to help him? I shot him in the face. Was that cool?
I shot him with my healing bullets. One of my college girlfriends was the one who actually showed them all to me, and I was like, these are fucking weird and cool, and it introduced me to that director whose name
Peter Chung.
Peter Chung. Yep. And it was funny because many years later, a couple years before now, he did an animated adaptation of the Fire Breather comics, which is right up my alley because it's all about kaiju and stuff.
Right.
But I got the Blu-ray, and on the Blu-ray, my Blu-ray is signed by one of the creators.
Matt Frank. I'm so important.
I am.
Sorry.
yes, and? No.
We can't let all the humble brags go by here.
Yeah, I know. But anyway, Phil Hester, that was the original artist, because he worked on Godzilla as well, and he actually knew who I was when I first introduced myself to him. Anyway, I picked up the Blu-ray, and I threw it on. There was actually a 2D animation test by Peter Chung, and it looks... Like, the final film is all CG, and it doesn't look bad.
Yeah.
But, God, like, his style with those characters is, whoa.
Uh-oh. This seems like a bad day. Bad day, L.A.
Looks fucking serious.
I heard you. I don't like tacos. What happened? Did you just take...
Whoa.
Do a flip. Okay.
It's the bad guy.
Zaitsev. These are probably some of the worst named characters we've ever seen in the video game. But
it's Japanese trying to name Western characters.
But still.
It's like, you know, the main character of Big O's name is Roger Smith.
And what?
His sidekick's name is R. Dorothy Wainwright.
That's a great name.
You remember Big O, right?
Oh, yeah.
Big O is the tits.
Actually, all I remember is the theme song. So
Big O.
Yeah, because it does say Big O a bunch of times.
Yeah.
Yep.
Cast in the name of God.
Do I have to fight this guy?
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus.
Fight him.
I was hoping I didn't have to do that yet.
Yep. You're fighting.
Bogey.
You're fighting.
Anyway, so can I tell you? I'll tell you guys.
Laser.
Yep, I got it. One more thing about Peter Chung before we move on. So a lot of people, I remember back in the old days, thought that the style of Aeon Flux was anime, which it is not. If you actually go and look, like I read an interview with him where he was like, his art style is very much inspired by, I forget what his nationality was, so I don't want to say it for certain.
Not Japanese.
It's not Japanese. He's a kind of a weird, like post-Renaissance, strange painter named Egon Schiele.
Whoa.
He was a friend of Gustav Klimt's, who a lot of people know who that is.
Right.
He did the Kiss, you know, that it's kind of a really interesting stylized type of thing.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's actually funny because I bought, when I found that out, I instantly became a fan of Egon Schiele and bought a book.
Interesting. Okay.
And the funniest,
sword.
Yeah. The thing, I played some Dark Souls 3 yesterday. So, you know.
No, you.
Jessica Jones.
Yeah, I know.
There's a, if you
I know
look,
of Miss Jones.
When you watch the Jessica Jones show, starring Jessica Jones, she, in her bedroom, has a picture on her wall.
Oh.
It's like, it's a pretty famous picture that I think a lot of people have seen. It's like a redheaded woman, like kind of in like workout-y clothes. It's just kind of like sitting with her kind of like tilted to one side.
Uh-huh.
And that's Egon Schiele.
Okay.
He made these very, very stylized. And if you look at any of his pictures, you will see immediately that, yes, this is exactly what the kind of weird spindly Aeon Flux style is. It's
okay.
It's not anime. It kind of looks anime because it's moving around and it's got a weird kind of form to
it.
A
weird sci-fi aesthetic that we don't usually see.
But it's not.
You're on fire.
It's actually got, well, I overheated. That's
okay.
I had to pop my heat sinks. Oh, shit.
Shit.
So, yeah, if you guys go look up War and look up Egon Schiele, and why are we fully in slow motion at this point? Beep, 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 beep.
I mean, fuck him up.
Don't get me wrong. I'm digging it, but I'm loving it.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Yeah, this is mesmerizing.
This guy is kind of...
sword!
Oh, shit.
Oh, shit.
Oh, we're having a fight. X.
X. X. X. X. X. X. X. X. X. X. X.
Oh, this is anime!
Shit!
Boom! What's up?
How you like me now?
Flip him off!
Oh,
super punch! Dude, why didn't we do that all the time? Why are we doing anything except for that?
Just energy punch.
Just energy punch all the time.
God, that was some serious, like, writer punch action. That was awesome.
Yeah, shoot him. Is it? Wait, you still have to sign the forms. Don't leave yet.
Oh, it's Dos Vidania. I thought it was Dos Vidania.
No, it's two Vidanias. It's part Mexican. It's part Spanish and part Russian. Double Vidania. Two Vidanias.
Jeff, shut up. That was, see, you see Sam's reaction? That was my reaction.
No, that was my reaction. Confirmed. Hey, only two. Only two this time.
We're doing better.
Yep, we're getting better. We didn't even get a death point deduction this time.
Jesus.
Yep.
All right.
Tactical challenges are now available. All right. So wait, is it the end of season one? Burger. Come up. So this is a rescue mission for you two.
My orders are classified. Not when we're on the line together. Oh my God.
Matt, do you like Vanquish?
Vanquish is really great, even though I think I prefer tacos.
You prefer tacos to Vanquish?
Delicious tacos.
I had a Doritos Locos taco for the first time the other day.
Did you now?
Yeah.
But did it taste like ass and recoil?
No, it tastes like Cool Ranch and recoil.
Well, it's mildly better. Yeah.
The least amount of butt in my mouth is that's like my mission statement for my life.
I mean, it depends on whose butt.
I'm going
depends
with,
on the ass.
Yeah. Okay. Let's just say I'm gonna say that, like,
sometimes you got to get your tongue in there.
90% of rectums I don't want anywhere near my. Actually, we'll go worldwide. 99.9% of rectums, nowhere near my mouth. There's a few. I make a few exceptions.
Uh-huh.
You know.
I would say I'm closer.
Barbara
personally.
Streisand, you know, is one. No, not.
Whoa.
Brad Pitt. I mean, you know, there's a couple out
there.
He's
a handsome guy.
Right.
I mean, I'd say I'm more closer to 40%.
40% buttholes not in your mouth?
Yeah.
That's you've made allowances for quite a few buttholes, my friend.
Some allowances.
Do you know how many people there are in this world?
Well,
that's a lot of people.
Making a lot of exceptions.
I mean, you know. Yeah. And so if you guys ever see Matt Frank at like a convention or something, you feel free to walk up and ask him if today's the day that you can put your butthole into his mouth face. And make sure to do it while other people are talking to him.
Yeah, really, just because it's one thing I love when I'm at a convention and I'm talking to people is when somebody else comes up and interrupts me.
Do you not like that? I don't know. I've actually made that part of my closing speech for all of the Rage Select videos recently.
Oh, yeah?
Also, you know.
Interrupt the shit out of your guests when they're at a convention.
Yeah, no, so.
Whoa.
Facebook, Twitter, here's some Amazon links, Patreon. Also, if you see Matt at a convention, please interrupt him, especially if he's talking to somebody who looks really important.
Really spread your cheeks.
Yeah, just take your pants
just
off.
Just cheeks forward, you know? Shit. Don't even look at me.
Yep, just. It's a crab walk up to him. Backwards crab walk.
Oh, my God.
Put are there still things over here? Oh, yeah, there's still things. Here, have a grenade, stupid.
you jerk.
You burnt.
You bugger. Shit,
robot. It was a robot.
Oh, man. Robots in disguise.
That was the worst Transformer I've ever seen.
No, it was like, functionally, the Cybertronian army will probably have a lot of use for that guy.
He's called Wallinator, Waltron, Wahlberg. That actually sounds like a Transformer name of a Transformer.
That's just what Mark Wahlberg will become in the next movie, is he will get
Damn, dude, look at how powered up my assault rifle is.
Goddamn, son.
Look at that thing. I'm like the admiral of assault rifles. Like, I don't even know what that
is. I know,
is.
That's how that works,
it's
but...
President
Assault Rifle. President Rifle Assault the Third.
That's right.
Yeah.
All right.
Anyway.
Ride the adjacent conveyor belt system. Okay. Sounds fun. Do you think there'll be any enemies shooting at us this whole time?
This is the scene This is the part I couldn't get past. This is where I stopped playing.
Oh, really?
Because I was like,
well, allow me to make a monkey out of you!
Woo!
No, it's woo. It's woo, woo, woo. That's woo. The monkey noise. Yeah. Well, that sounds like a monkey that's got to poop real bad or something.
You do the Donkey Kong thing.
Hey, look, maybe get behind this. Hey, Santa! Get up, Santa! Oh, shit.
That wasn't
ouch,
Santa.
Ouch. You can stop making the monkey noises now.
But I'm doing the Donkey Kong thing.
Don't do the Donkey Kong.
His coconut gun can fire in first if he shoots ya.
What are you talking? Are you just making?
That was the Donkey Kong 64 theme song. Okay. That was the monkey rap.
We established earlier that I had never had an N64. Just rub it in my face, why don't you? Why don't you do that? Why don't you rub it in my face?
You didn't play Turok 2?
No.
Shit.
Yeah. I didn't play Turok 1.
Ugh.
I didn't play Turok 0.
You know, didn't they just remake Turok?
Yeah, actually, we played it for a Patreon video.
Oh, man. Caught up on
it's like
that.
John
awesome.
And I playing it. It's like some of these games, when you don't have the nostalgia to back it up, they do
they
not
the
age well. Yeah.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Shit.
I saw a couple of gameplay videos for it. Really, it was kind of brainless fun.
I mean, it's one of those things that really shows you how much evolution there's been in
gaming.
Just, like, yeah, it just... The way that the amount of production value that we expect in our gaming. Because
right, exactly.
It's like, what am I doing and why am I doing it and where am I and what the fuck is that?
Yeah.
Is that a waterfall? Oh, shit. Look at all these. Look at all these chicken walkers. Oops, shit. That was a waste of missile.
I got to look up what those are because I'm thinking about what those things are called in Robotech. And I remember the first time we saw those, I was like, what are those called? So hang on.
Chicken walkers.
No.
They're all chickens.
Well, they are chickens, but they're, hang on.
Robo chickens.
No, not Tobo Peck.
Tobo Peck. Tobo Peck Generations. That's my
Robotech. I'll just go to the Robotech wiki because I'm sure.
Man,
I
need to go watch Macross Plus again.
Oh man, I did it in my window that had all my Elsa and Anna incest porn. Hang on.
These are not details that the audience needs, Matthew.
Yeah, they are.
These are not.
Clearly.
No, nobody needs to know this.
Fictional chronology. Though, uh-huh. That's not it. Television and film, Robotech, kids, I don't care,
uh-huh.
I don't care,
uh-huh.
I don't care.
Yeah, he doesn't care, folks.
Fuck, come on, where is it?
Yeah,
I'm
right
not going to spend the entire episode.
Matt.
What?
Wait, watch this. It's going to be awesome. You see these stairs?
Uh-huh.
You see the stairs?
Oh, jeez.
Ow, my knees, they hurt so bad.
It's burning. Jesus.
Uh-oh.
Okay, Robotech.
These Russian
army. Roboitech.
Roboitech, yep.
Enemies.
Yep.
All right.
Roboitech.com.
Those are Robotech characters.
Yep.
The Super Dimensional Macross.
Yep.
The Shadow Chronicles.
Right. Yep.
Okay.
Garbage.
Rick Hunter.
Yep.
He is super Japanese.
Isn't what you're talking about, the things that you're talking about,
yeah.
Aren't those from like a second series that was actually like
integrated.
Like it wasn't
Robotech
in Japan.
It was like Bullspeeder or something like that.
And then like when they brought it over, they decided, okay, it's Robotech now, bitch. Like,
yeah, yeah. Well, that's what they used to do all the time.
Oh, wow.
I mean, that's how they made VR Troopers. They're Claudia Grant. I don't want the heroes. I want the enemies.
They're all Zentradi, man. They're always like.
Are they Zentradi? Okay.
Well, no, those were the ones in the original, but.
Right, but they had these robot things.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about. I had an action figure for one of them. Okay. They were purple. They had claws.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
They're
Mighty Morphing.
No.
Macross Rangers.
No.
Power Macross.
Yes. No.
Mega Zords.
They're just Shut up. The third. Okay. Mm-hmm. One is called, oh, Jesus. Okay, the white ones with the chicken legs.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
Are called.
Well, that's one way to kill a turret.
The white ones are called Roy Quamney Glaug.
That's not a real word.
That's what it says.
None of those are words.
No, look, see? Roy Quamney Glaug.
Okay, what were they called in the U.S. version?
That's what they're called.
That's not what they were called in the U.S. version.
Okay, hang on. This might be the. But this is for the. Oh, no, they are called Zentradi in the Japanese version. Are they called Zentradi in the American version?
Well, the bad guys are... The race is called Zentradi. Those were just like their mechas,
I'm putting this away. Fuck it.
Yep. Oh, no!
No!
Oh!
Yeah.
You're my favorite.
Oh, wait, you know what? It's probably on eBay. The toys are probably on eBay, and they probably have the names for them.
Oh, no, those aren't the ones that I was thinking of. The ones that I was thinking of, I think, were from the motorcycle Macross.
Oh, shit. That's the one... That was like Volspeeder or whatever it's called. I'm sure I'm getting that wrong.
Wait, are we? Okay. Are these bad guys or are these good guys? Oh, these bad guys.
Yeah, bad guys.
Combat Santa! Dude, if Combat Santa would let us use his giant chain gun, I feel like that would be
better. We would end this.
Right.
Most Speeda. That's what the second series was called with the motorcycles.
Okay, well, I got nine kills that time.
No, not porn. I don't want Robotech. I mean, I'll forward that Robotech porn for later. But
yeah. What is it? What is it? Mostly mid-May? Mostly just mid-May?
Yeah.
Fuck mid-May.
Sprinter butt cheeks.
Fucking mid-May. I don't like her. I'm gonna defeat you with the power of song. It's like, thank you,
well,
mid-May.
Well, no, see, I actually think that's kind of okay because
you would.
The whole idea. Shut up. The whole idea is that we're defeating the bad guys with our culture.
No, I gotcha. No, I understand.
I'm not saying it's not fucking stupid. I'm just saying.
Well, I am. See, that's the thing, is that I understand it, Matt. I'm not an idiot.
There's Min-May.
But I just don't think it... I think it's kind of dumb, personally.
Okay.
What is this amazing music? It's making me feel things I've never felt before. I don't want to invade anybody anymore.
Oh, my God. $279? Yeah. Shit.
Honestly telling me that no Zentradi was ever like, Mentos, or like... that, like like hummed two things.
Mentos fresh and
fine. Do you know what the... there's an audio effect, Matt? Are we out of time?
We got a couple minutes left.
Okay, I'll do this. But there's an audio effect. Have you ever heard this? Where if you take like a person saying a thing, like if I said like peanut butter sandwich, right?
Yeah.
And if you record that and then you just start playing it back on a loop, your
peanut
brain,
butter sandwich, peanut butter sandwich, peanut.
It doesn't matter how I said it. Like, say if I just said peanut butter sandwich, like in a very monotone voice, and you play it back on repeat, your brain will make it sound like I'm singing it eventually.
Well, yeah, because your brain wants rhythm to your voice, and your brain is interpreting it a certain way.
So you're saying the Zentradi are just idiots? Like, they never...
Well, their entire culture is based on war.
Yeah, but, you know, there's, like, all kinds of battle songs. There's, like, little... They used to give drums to fucking, like, eight-year-olds and shit. Like, they never figured any of this shit out? Come on, Zentradi. Don't be so dumb. Don't be so dumb, Zentradi.
Oh, come on. They're, you know, all I remember, see, I never saw Robotech when it was first on television. I saw it when they briefly had it on Toonami, and like Tom, you know,
Arnold.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
Yeah.
Tom on Toonami was like, we're fucking bringing it. We didn't say fucking at the time, but he's like, we're bringing back Robotech.
Yo, bitch, we're bringing it back. Yeah.
And
he's
like, it was so funny because he as a character would make like, he would like act like an actual like fan, and he would say things like Thundercats, the greatest cartoon ever made.
That's not
and,
true. Like, Thundercats is not the greatest cartoon ever made.
I know, but it's like,
stop lying, Tom.
It's
you're
hilarious.
You're deceiving a whole generation.
Well, then he would talk anyway. So when the only episode I remember from Robotech that I actually watched was the one where those couple main characters got captured, and the Zentradi, like these Zentradi were like looking at them. They're like, what is it with these female humans are different. And then
microids, I believe they called them, because they were so small.
Yeah,
the Zentradi were so big.
Yeah, exactly. Yep. And then like they were, and then the girl had to convince the guy to kiss him because he's like, you have to kiss me.
Yeah,
you have to kiss me, or else you're gonna kill us. And it's like, why do they care?
That was that Rick Hunter? It was Rick Hunter.
I guess it
and
was.
Then the and then like Lisa, I
Lisa
believe.
Hayes. Yeah,
Lisa Hayes. Who was the guy? Roy.
The big guy?
No. He was like the badass. He was blonde. He had the dark, like, I think his name was Roy something.
Darkstar.
No, Roy. Oh god, it's on the tip of my fucking tongue.
I don't know, man.
Ah, fuck. It's Roy something.
I can look it up.
Jesus, give me like a second.
I'm looking it up.
You look it up, but keep it prime.
Yep.
But hey, spoilers for a fucking 30-year-old or 40-year-old cartoon. There's an episode where he dies, and it was really emotional to me as a kid.
Okay, Roy, his name.
Not Hunter.
Roy something.
Roy. Because Lisa was all broken up. It was like mid-May and fucking what's his face? And then like Roy. And Lisa, and then Roy died, and then I'm probably getting that all wrong. But I do know that there was a guy named Roy.
No.
What's his name? Okay. Fuck, dude, don't quit looking at mid-May porn. Nobody's likes it.
You can't stop me.
You can't tell me what to do.
Max Sterling.
Wait, maybe it was Max. Maybe it wasn't Roy.
Okay, hang on. I'm going to Max's entry.
See the guy with the blonde hair? Like the.
He doesn't have a picture.
Damn it!
Rick Hunter's, he was Black Group, Vermilion Team, and Skull Squadron. Max Rise of the Park, No, Max got married in the series.
No, I think I know who you're talking about. I don't think that's who I'm talking about. I could be just making this shit up. I could be just completely. Just do a search on Google Image for like.
Robotech Roy,
yeah.
Roy
Fokker! Roy Fokker! F O K K E R, like the.
Yeah, it is Roy Fokker!
Yeah, like
no,
the.
My God, I can't believe they did that!
Yeah. Like the German airplanes. Anyway, I think we're just about out of time, right?
Yeah, we're
probably just a little bit over time.
Yeah, we are out of time.
Okay, well, folks, if you're watching this on YouTube, hit the like and subscribe button. If you'd like to see these videos a day earlier, head on over to RageSelect.com, buy it on Amazon, go to Patreon, and
shaky.
Help support us by giving us money, and we give you bonus videos.
Woo!
Maximum bonus in return. Join us back here for a Sequential Saturday every Saturday. That's why it's called Sequential Saturday.
My God.
Quickly, tell the people where they can find you on interwebs.
They can find me at MattFrankArt.com, Spankzilla on Tumblr and Twitter.
Okay.
Kaiju Samurai on DeviantArt. Your Project Nemesis, Godzilla Rulers of Earth. Some other shit is coming out.
Okay, and fart noise.
Fartnoise.com.
Okay, fartnoise.com.
We'll look that up.
That's a different website. Don't go to fartnoise.com. We will see you next week, folks. Thank you so much for joining us and listening to the rambles. We'll see you next time. Fartnoise.com.